the triangle holds some of the world's deepest waters. With the Gulf of Alaska reaching down to depths of an incredible 26,000 feet. Could this be a perfect hiding place for a secret underwater alien base?
There's definitely underwater UFO activity that's been reported over the last four decades. These UFOs have been tracked underwater and stayed underwater for a long time, evaded the Navy, and they go so deep that we don't know where they're going. I am very convinced that there's some kind of base underwater.
UFO researcher Johnny Enoch has been looking at the evidence.
According to my sources, there are extraterrestrial bases under the water off the coast of Alaska. Alaska's the perfect place for extraterrestrials to set up underwater bases. I mean, you have 33,000 miles of untapped coast and over 3 million lakes. I mean, where better a place to set up shop?
I've been researching through, and there's a number of reports I find of disks coming out of the ocean near Alaska. This particular report happened all the way back in the summer of 1945.
An Army transporter ship, U.S. Delaroff, was heading past Adak, one of the Aleutian Islands, in the southwest corner of Alaska. Suddenly, one of the crew was said to have spotted ripples in the water just a mile from their vessel.
In this report from one of the crew members, he stated that he turned and saw a large round object which just emerged from the sea.
They witnessed a UFO come up out of the water that was 150 to 200 feet wide. And it started circling the boat and making everyone feel rather uneasy.
1945. That could be quite startling to see a 150, 250 foot circular object come out of the ocean. Totally quiet. It was on its own propulsion system, wasn't affected by the wind, the sailors said.
This mysterious, unidentified flying object was said to be in range of the ship's guns. But the crew held their fire for fear of provoking an attack.
It circled around the ship two or three times until it took off, leaving everyone mesmerized.
The crew kept watch as U.S. Delaroff continued on its voyage to Seattle. But there were no further reported sightings of the UFO.
All 14 members of the crew witnessed this, including the radioman, and they signed a summary and reported this when they got back to shore.
Mysteriously, the top secret report compiled by the crew never saw the light of day. Dan believes he's identified a pattern.
They're all strikingly similar. All the reports that I've researched through, people see things coming up under the ocean, and they shoot off at tremendous speeds.
Could these UFO encounters be proof of an underwater alien base in Alaska? If so, why would such an advanced life form be attracted to its waters? UFO researcher Johnny Enoch has been investigating.
In the reports I've heard about extraterrestrial craft coming in and out of the water, it's usually because there is an underwater network that they're accessing, where they may enter in one spot and leave from another. Some have said the UFOs are using wormholes as a superhighway to connect to other places in the universe.
Johnny believes he's found a precedent for an alien base in Alaska's waters. Using satellite imagery, he's found what he thinks is an abandoned extraterrestrial structure in the Pacific Ocean off the Californian coast.
What we're looking at here is some underwater footage off the coast of Malibu, and it's absolutely incredible. We have signs of an advanced civilization due to the architectonics here. We have several pillars all lined up in a symmetrical fashion, and there appears to be some sort of a lintel or doorway in the front of it. And even if you look at the top of it, it's got this roof-like structure. Perhaps this is the remains of an ancient and advanced civilization. I think we very well could be looking at an underwater alien base.
Back in Alaska, the reported sightings of UFOs over its seas have continued right up to present day. Most notably, around Smitty's Cove, 60 miles from Anchorage. Locals have reported something strange lurking in the waters.
I saw thousands and thousands of those ships out there. I was freaked out.
If aliens have set up home in the oceans, it could only be here in the Alaska Triangle.
Our Earth is 70% water, and we've explored 5%. There are trenches, deep water trenches. Some of the coastlines are 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 feet deep. So there's so many places to hide things underwater. Naturally, extraterrestrials would be heading underwater. It's a great place to hide. They've probably been doing it for centuries.
Debbie Ziegelmeyer has carried out over 800 investigations for MUFON, the Mutual UFO Network. She is their director of underwater research.
Investigating is like a mystery novel. Every piece of evidence gets a little bit closer to solving the mystery.
Debbie's investigation is now centering on Alaska. In the southeast of the triangle, off the coast of Anchorage, she's found some intriguing satellite images.
I thought it would be a good idea to take a look at satellite images. So I started a little bit east, right along the bottom line of the Alaska Triangle. I found some very interesting things underwater. I'm not really sure about them. Some interesting lines, almost like roadways, some type of like a structure. I actually found almost like underwater highways. And then alongside of it, there's rocks that just look out of place, funny shapes. But mainly what intrigued me were what looks like highways underwater.
Could these markings signify an alien superhighway that leads to a covert underwater headquarters? There have been compelling reports of UFOs along the coast here. One comes from Beverly Waltz, who had a startling experience one evening at her home near to Smitty's Cove in Whittier.
I was looking out my window just because I like to look out over the water, and I had noticed something odd going on out there over the mountains. I saw these objects, like all these different lights. And so I took my binoculars and I was looking out and I saw the ships. They came from very low, just rising up. It just seems like thousands and thousands of those ships out there. Coming up, 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 up. Up, up, up. And then when they got up into the skyline where you couldn't see anymore, it would just like, psh, so fast and just disappear. I was freaked out. I was just like, what is that? What's going on? So, really strange. Had never seen anything like it. Nothing that our military has. I didn't attribute it to anything man-made. Is what I'm trying to say.